Hello friends, today we will discuss about dry bulb temperature and wet bulb temperature. What is dry bulb temperature? It is the temperature of the ambient air which is exposed freely to the thermometer. In this case, the condition of the bulb is dry. A moisture-free air is exposed to the thermometer and the temperature of the air is detected by the thermometer. We have to ensure that dry bulb temperature should be free from radiation and moisture. Coming to wet bulb temperature. In wet bulb temperature, a wet cloth is surrounded to the bulb. So when the atmospheric air is exposed to the wet bulb thermometer, an evaporation process takes place due to the wet condition of the cloth. As the evaporation process takes place, the cooling will happen in this zone. For example, if we take an example of pot, we always think that how water will get cool in the pot. So this is as simple as that the evaporation process is taking place in the water pot. You can see that pot having a fine minor porous holes where the ambient air in and out will take place. Due to this process, evaporation of water will take place and cooling will happen. Similarly, here also evaporation process is taking place and hence cooling is happening. That is the reason we can always see that small temperature difference between dry bulb temperature and wet bulb temperature. And the temperature of dry bulb is high compared to that of wet bulb temperature. So, in the case of wet bulb temperature, we have to ensure that it should be free from moisture. The air what we expose should be free from moisture. Otherwise, we cannot get the exact wet bulb temperature and the difference between dry bulb and wet bulb temperature will vary. This exercise will help us to estimate the real relative humidity of air. If the relative humidity is high, the difference between dry bulb temperature and wet bulb temperature will decrease. So, if the relative humidity is 100%, we can say that dry bulb temperature is equal to wet bulb temperature. This is a very basic concept in refrigeration system and it is very important to understand this concept, especially for air conditioning mechanics as well as engineers. Thank you for watching the video. Please like and share the video and subscribe my channel. Thank you.